Hi there, Pam Coburn-Litvak here. In the final part of my series on cognitive therapy, let's meet Jessica. Jessica's a high achiever who excels at a lot of things, but she often rains on her own parade by putting herself or her accomplishments down. For example, her friends and family praise her for her last recital performance. That was so good, they all say. But Jessica just brushes them all off. Yeah, it was okay, I guess, but I should have done better. Jessica is using a distorted thought pattern called discounting the positive. At first glance, it sounds like the negative mental filter distortion we talked about earlier. A negative mental filter is like colorblindness. We ignore the positive because we simply can't see it. But discounting the positive is worse. Those with this distortion can still see the positives in their lives, but insidiously turn them into something negative. A mistake, a fluke, an outlier, or a misunderstanding. It's often phrased as a yes, but statement. Jessica says, "Yes, I did okay at the recital, but you just didn't hear all the mistakes I made." Here's some other examples. "Yes, I got the promotion, but only because no one else wanted it." "Yes, I was invited, but they just felt sorry for me." "Yes, I got an A, but only because it was an easy test." You've probably heard the old saying, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Discounting the positive reverses this process by making us think that anything good must be, at its core, something sour and dour. Jessica may look confident, but she suffers from social anxiety and depression. She worries about her mistakes and how others will judge her. Her friends and family try to encourage her by pointing out the positives in her life. Sometimes she seems downright mad that people are trying to cheer her up. She fights them off with a seemingly endless supply of yes but rebuttals. Psychiatrist David Burns says that this distortion is like having a relentless critic running around our brains, just waiting to tear down any positive we or others might say. When someone tells Jessica, "Don't be so negative, can't you see the silver lining?" her inner critic just says, "Don't be so positive, can't you see the big dark cloud? And your stupid silver lining is probably just a mirage anyway." You can see that piling on more positives just doesn't work on this distortion. So we have to ambush it from a new and unexpected direction. Cognitive therapy can help us with this. Here, let's focus on one technique that psychiatrists find very powerful in fighting this distortion. If your negative thoughts often end in feelings of shame and poor self-esteem, this technique is worth trying. It often surprises and stumps our inner critics into silence. It involves agreeing with them as far as possible, accepting the grains of truth with a sense of humor and inner peace. We call this the acceptance paradox. After her recital, Jessica feels really down on herself. Her inner critic is mad at the mistakes she made and worried what others will think of her. But instead of defending herself against these negative thoughts, Jessica decides to try to agree with the grains of truth in them with a sense of humor and inner peace. Jessica's inner critic says, "You'll never make it as a professional musician." Jessica says, "I agree and accept that there are better musicians than I am right now. I admire them." "You'll never be as good as they are. You're nothing." "I don't understand what you mean by nothing. Maybe you mean that I don't play as well as others do, which is true. I agree and accept that I still have a lot to learn, and my teacher is helping me with that." "Your teacher thinks you stink too." "My teacher knows what my weaknesses are. That's what makes her a good teacher." "You don't even deserve a teacher like her. How do you even have the nerve to show up at your lessons?" "It's pretty easy, actually. I just accept that it's okay to make mistakes because that's how I learn. I would only fail if I give up." Those of us who suffer from depression and anxiety often think we have accepted ourselves in this sense. We agree that we are inferior, pathetic, and worthless human beings. When our inner critic says, "Face it, you're nobody," we say, "You're right, that's exactly what I am." This isn't what we're going for. In fact, this is the essence of discounting the positive, trampling underfoot all that God has given us, stealing our joy and peace. This unhealthy acceptance destroys self-worth, decreases our motivation, and stunts our personal growth. Healthy acceptance does just the opposite. It protects our self-worth, increases motivation, and nurtures our growth. It understands that we are still on the journey. Please like and share this content and take a few seconds to subscribe. Thanks so much.